The next theorem in simple random sampling is nothing but the statement is show that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean in SRS or SRSWR. So here you need to prove that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population in SRS. In examination you should check whether it is simple random sampling or stratified random sampling. So before going to prove this, let us recall the notation which we have used for population mean and sampling mean in SRS. Population mean we indicate with y bar n, which is nothing but 1 by n. Please take out your notation page from your notes. Y bar n is equals to 1 by n, sigma I is equal to n to n yi. Now, what is sample mean? As I said you that population characteristics are indicated with capital letters and those of sample with small letters. Y bar n is equal to 1 by n, sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi. The same, I said you the same can also be written in this way, which is in this is in terms of small letters. The same can be written in terms of capital letters in this way, where 1 by n sigma ai sigma I is equal to 1 to n ai yi, where ai is a variable which takes two values 1 comma 0 with expectation of ai is equal to n by n. This also I said you while giving the notation e of ai is equal to n by n. Now you need to prove that. What is the statement here? You need to prove that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. You need to prove that. How do you when do you say an estimator is unbiased estimator? If expectation of t is equal to theta, the same concept. Sample means if expectation of y bar n is equal to capital Y bar n, we call this this y bar n we call as unbiased estimator of capital Y bar n. That is, sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. Means it is sufficient to prove expectation of e bar y bar expectation of y bar n is equal to capital Y bar n. Let us consider the LHS, which is nothing but expectation of y bar n. What is the formula for y bar n? Y bar n formula is 1 by n sigma I is equal to, you have two definitions, we are going to use the second one. So the same can also be written as 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to capital N ai yi. Now we are writing that ai is a variable. Am I right? Here, this is a variable, ai is variable, and this is a constant. You know that expectation of cx is equal to c into expectation of x. We know that this result is nothing but c into expectation of x, where x is the variable, c is a constant. Similarly, here as ai is the variable, and n and yi are constants, so you can take out 1 by n, sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi, expectation of ai. Okay, is this step clear? You need to prove e of yn is equal to y bar n. I considered the expectation of small y bar n. I wrote the formula, original formula, and that in terms of capital n and capital yi. Now if I take expectations here n, yi are constants, ai is the variable. So out of the, we can take out this 1 by n and yi from this expectation. So you'll get 1 by n, sigma I is equal to 1 to capital N, expectation of ai. What is expectation of ai? Expectation of ai is nothing but n by n. Again, with respect to the summation is running on I, this term is independent of I, we can take out of the summation. So this becomes you have considered this, you have already here 1 by n and sigma I is equal to 1. This is the last step which we wrote there. So 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n, this is n by n into yi. As this is independent of I, we can take out of the sigma 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi. These two will cancel and you will get 1 by n sigma I is equal to, this is sorry, capital N, capital N yi. So this is nothing but pi bar n, which is nothing but population mean. So we got expectation of small y bar n is equal to capital y bar n, which indicates that sample mean is unbiased estimator of population mean. Okay, this is the second theorem. Let us now do the third theorem also. Now the statement is, in SRS WOR, show that sample mean square is an unbiased estimator of population mean square. Very important one. So take out your notation. What is small s square? Mean square means we write with capital S square. Here you need to prove sample mean square is unbiased estimator of population mean square. This is population mean square and this is sampling mean square. So this in words, this is the statement: sample mean square is unbiased estimator of population. Using the notation, this is what we need to prove. Okay, you need to prove that sample mean square is unbiased estimator of population mean square, that is E of S square is equal to capital S square. So let us start the proof here. It's a lengthy one when compared to the previous one. Now, let us again write the population mean square. Take out, better you take out your notation page. Population mean square error, we write that with S square, which is nothing but 1 by population means, which involves all the capital letters. I is equal to 1 to n, yi minus y bar n whole square. Sample mean square error, we indicate with small s square, which is nothing but in place of capital N, you will get small I is equal to 1 to n, yi minus y bar n. These are the definitions in notation. Capital S square is 1 by n minus 1, yi minus y bar n whole square. S square is 1 by n minus 1, small n minus 1, I is equal to 1 to n, yi minus y bar n I whole square. Where, what again, you have y bar n here. What is y bar n formula? 1 by n sigma yi. What is small y bar n formula? 1 by n sigma yi. Now, to prove this, what you need to prove here? E of s square is equal to, you need to prove this. Before proving this, let us consider s square here. What is the formula for s square? 1 by n minus 1, sigma I is equal to 1 to n, yi minus y bar n whole square. Let us simplify this s square, then let us take expectations to show the result. What it gets to prove this, I am not directly considering the expectations. First let us consider sample mean square error and let us simplify it first. Let us take this as equation number 1. Now, so let us, it is in the form of a minus b whole square. Let us expand this. Okay, s square is equal to 1 by n minus 1, sigma I is equal to 1 to n. This is a minus b whole square means a square plus b square minus 2ab. Okay, this is 1 by n minus 1, sigma I is equal to 1 to n. Okay, sigma yi square plus y bar n square. This one is nothing but 2 yi into y bar n. Now let us take this summation to each and every term. 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square plus sigma y bar n square minus 2 sigma yi y bar n. I think here the summation is from I to 1 to small n. So this is the first, there is no constant term here. So you will get this as it is. Here summation is I is equal to n to 1 to n. There is no I here. So we can write that as n into y bar n square minus, you have this summation is running on I. We can take out this y bar n out of the summation. 2 y bar n sigma yi. I have expanded this sigma, I have applied this sigma to each and every term. Wherever I is not involved, I am writing that n into the term. This is sigma yi square plus n y bar n square minus 2 y bar n. Okay, what is small y bar n you have? What is the formula for y bar n? Sample mean 1 by n sigma yi. So, if you cross multiply here, so sigma yi is nothing but n into y bar n. Okay, here sigma yi can be replaced with n into y bar n. Now I'll rewrite the step again. S square as 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square plus n into y bar n square minus 2. Already we have y bar n, sigma yi we have substituted it with n into y bar n. So this is 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square plus n y bar n square minus 2 n y bar n square. So 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square, you have plus n minus 2n, which you will get as n into y bar n square. So you got s square is equal to 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square minus n into y bar n into y bar n square. Now let us take this 1 by n minus 1 to each and every term. Now write the first term as it is, okay. Now what is the formula for y bar n? Y bar n is nothing but 1 by n sigma yi. Now I am going to replace this y bar n with 1 by n sigma yi whole square. This is 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square minus n by n minus 1 into, this is 1 by n square sigma yi whole square. Okay, it is 1 by n square. This is not sigma yi square, this is sigma yi whole square. This is 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square. Minus 1 n will get cancelled, so you will get n into n minus 1 sigma yi whole square. Now let us expand this. Here I am going to give a small explanation for this. Many times I have repeated that sigma x square is different from sigma x whole square. So if I write sigma y whole square, the square is for sigma and as well as for y. So if you take, as I said, you 1, 2, 3 values. Sigma x square means 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, which is nothing but 1 plus 4 plus 9. 1 plus 4 plus 9, which is nothing but 14. Sigma x whole square means 1 plus 2 plus 3. You need to add all the values and then you need to square it. 6 square, which is nothing but 36. Means sigma x square is not equal to sigma x whole square. So, you cannot say that these two are same. Got it, girls? We have y bar n, I have replaced with 1 by n sigma yi whole square. I have taken this 1 by n square out and I have sigma yi whole square. Means this simply I cannot write that as sigma yi square, because this sigma we have, this square is also for y. Using this result, we cannot this simply write as sigma yi square. Then what does this sigma yi whole square becomes? This becomes as, this is like sigma means total. If you take two values, y1 plus y2 whole square, how much you'll get? Sum of the square terms you'll get, sum of the product terms you'll get, y1, y2, y2, y1 plus y2 square. Means first try to understand this, these two terms are not same. Sigma yi square is this, sigma yi whole square, these two are not same. Then what does that sigma yi whole square represents? Sigma yi means first you need to add these two observations, then you need to square. If I put I is equal to 1 here and if I take 2 here, actually we have n terms here. I am considering for your sake only two observations. Then I will write that as y1 plus y2 whole square. I'll get y1 square plus y2 square plus y1 y2 plus y2 y1. We observe that we are getting some square terms and also some product terms. So this sigma yi whole square now can be replaced with sigma yi square plus yi yj. Okay. So again I'll write the last step, 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square minus 1 by n into n minus 1 sigma yi whole square. Just now we have discussed that these two are not same. First point to be noted, those two are not same. Then what does the second term represents? As it is square, you'll get some of the product terms and some of the square terms. If you expand a plus b whole square, you'll get a square plus b square plus some product terms. If a plus b plus c whole square is there, if there are three terms also, you'll get some product terms and some square terms. So you'll get squared terms sigma yi square and sigma yi yj. Here I is equal to 1 to n, I is equal to 1 to n. So you got this as 1 by n minus 1 sigma yi square minus 1 by n into n minus 1. Let us take this 1 n by n into n minus 1 for the first term and second term, sigma yi square plus into minus minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj. Now we can take out sigma yij square common from the first two terms. You'll get, and also 1 by n minus 1. This is also common for those. You'll get 1 here, 1 minus 1 by n minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj. I is equals to 1 to small n. This is also, as we have small letters here, 1 to small n. 1 by n minus 1. If you take LCM here, n minus 1 by n sigma I is equal to 1 to n yi square minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj. This is 1 by n sigma yi square minus 1 into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj. So all these are small letters. Just know we did theorem number 2, where expectation of small y bar n is equal to capital Y bar n. There, instead of considering y bar n is equal to 1 by small n sigma yi, we have converted that into capital letters. So let us convert this is in small letters to take the expectations. Okay, let us write that in this conversion is important. The small letters can be written into capital letters in this way. Here also n into n minus 1, you have small yi yj. As you have only one variable here, you have introduced only one ai. You have yi yj, so you are going to get ai aj converted into, whenever you have a capital A's, the small y's will be converted into capital Y, as we did there in the notation also I gave you. Up to we have small letters here, okay. This is still S square only. Now I want to write, before taking expectations for this, I want to write the same in terms of capital letters. Whenever you want to change from small to capital letters, you should introduce the corresponding AIs. Yes, you have only one suffix here, you'll get only AI. Here YI YJ means you'll get AI AJ. Now what is expectation of AI? N by N. What is expectation of AI AJ? That is nothing but n into n minus 1 by n into n. You remember this part. Expectation of AI is equal to n by n. Expectation of AI AJ is equal to n into n minus 1 by n into n minus 1. Now, till you have written the expression for S square. How much you got? S square as 1 by n sigma AI YI square. Before taking expectations, they should be converted into capital letters by introducing AI AJ. So this is small S square 1 by n sigma. I said you that this is a constant. If you take AI YI square minus 1 by n into n minus 1 sigma expectation of AI AJ YI YJ. I said you that A's are the variables. So you can take out yi square out of the expectation of ai minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into, you can take out this expectation of ai aj. What is expectation of ai? Just now we wrote expectation of ai is n by n minus 1 by n into n minus 1 sigma yi yj. What is expectation of ai aj? N into n minus 1 into capital N into n minus 1. So along with n by n, you are getting for this n minus 1, n minus 2. These two cancels. So how much you got? You got 1 by n sigma yi square minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj, where these are from 1 to capital N. We have converted. I said you that after introducing ai, that changes into capital N. So, if you look into the theorem, while simplifying s square, we got this one. We arrived at we have equation number 3 here, where let us name this as equation number 3. Which one? This one. Let it be equation number 3. Which what you got for small s square as 1 by n sigma yi square minus 1 by n into n minus 1 into sigma yi yj. Here after taking expectation, how much you got? If you compare equation number 3 with here, if you compare equation number 3 here you have 1 by small n, here you have 1 by capital N. Here the summation is from 1 to n, here it is from 1 to capital N. Means here whatever you have in expression 3, all those are with small letters. Here the same expression with capital letters. There the LHS is capital small s square, as all are small. Here all we have capital letters. So we can write that as s square. So we have proved that sample mean square is unbiased estimator of population mean square. Thank you.